maybe they had one book at home.
A Bible.
A Bible. But they could not read the Bible for two reasons. First, the Bible was in Latin language. Okay, Martin Luther translated the Bible. You lost your green umbrella?
Yes. Thank you very much.
One of the five.
So, it was Martin Luther translated the Bible in 1522, but the printing system of Gutenberg was not like nowadays, and who could afford a German Bible? And even if you would have a German Bible in those days, second reason why they could not read the Bible, they were literate, they could not read. So when they came to a church, every fresco told them a story about Old and New Testament. He told them, listen, you have a very poor, miserable life now. Fight against cold, against black plague, against hunger, against dark. Later on, after death, you will be in heaven. That's it all about. And to feel the baroque, all your five senses, in churches you have lots of angels, fruits, flowers, all the stuff wrong. A big organ for your ears. Incense to your reserves for your nose and the hosty for your tongue. To feel the baroque with all your five senses. And maybe I could tell you about this script, painting up there, the lady, the fertile, there are three rivers up there. You won't see the rivers, but the symbols for the rivers. You see the fertile lady with the blue ribbon, that is Danube. In the front there is a lady with a mussel. Sweet water pearl oyster, that is the Ilse with the bed. And the white man with the tree, that is the Inn River. And if you want to do a little bit of walking after dinner, after lunch, the Inn River is not very far, it's very narrow from here to walk to the Inn River. And it's, it could be not too long with the whole group, but in the afternoon you easily can do it on your own. Walk to the other side and walk down to the Inn River. It's the most beautiful river, the green wild river, and you can look up the hills, and behind the pilgrimage church is Austria, so it's really very nice to do a little walk over the pedestrian crossing to the other side. You see it on your map, you can't get lost, to the shores of the Inn River and walk down maybe to the point where the three rivers are coming together and back to your boat. That's very nice, very easy to walk, and you will think of me, it's beautiful sight, beautiful view. In front, first of all, King again, Max Joseph. Interesting here on the left side we have Passau before the fire. Romanic style, you see the twin towers, they were really Romanic style. And here Passau after the fire when they rebuilt the Gothic side. And this building in church with the long staircase, that's on the other side of the Inn River, which you will see when you walk to the Inn River. There are 321 steps. You can pray up the rosary. Oh, that is also a suggestion for the gentlemen while the ladies are drinking a latte, like a cappuccino maybe. Pray up 321 steps. Every wish will be fulfilled because Kaiser Leopold prayed there. You know, Kaiser Leopold, he lived in 1683 and he had a big problem because a Turkish sultan called Mehmet was standing in front of the doors of Vienna. And he wanted to bring the Ottoman people to the Christians. And what did Kaiser Leopold do? He was a coward, as many men in those days. he took his wife, his mistress, and he went to Passau. And he prayed in his church for the victory over the Turkish. His prayers got heard. The Turkish could not take over Vienna in 1683. So it's a very famous pilgrimage church. But the gentlemen don't look very enthusiastic about my idea. But underneath the staircase is one of our five breweries. That might change your mind. By the way, you know we have also in Bavaria five seasons. Spring, summer, autumn, winter, and
Oktoberfest.
No, it's only 280 years in history. That's not a lot. Too young for us. The fifth season is strong beer season, and that is 6 weeks before Easter. The early monks in 1100 they had to fast sweeps before Easter, Lente, starts on Ash Wednesday, Lent. And the legend says that the monks decide beer is liquid food.
Yes, that's true.
That's good. They thought we are not allowed to eat a lot, but we are allowed to drink, and beer is liquid food, so maybe we can brew a very strong beer. They were not sure, so they sent a barrel of beer from Bavaria to Rome. Now, Bavaria, Rome, it's very easy. We go to Venice, 300 miles to Venice, highways, tunnels, BMW, you know how to drive. There we are. But in the early days, 1100, you had to climb the Alps, Brenner. There were no highways, no tunnels, so it took a long time to bring them this barrel of beer to the Pope in Rome. And when it arrived, it was not in the best state anymore. And then they asked the Pope, they said, Holy Pope, do you allow us to drink this beer during bathing season? And the Pope said, what should I answer? I have to taste it. And he tasted the beer and it was so bitter, so that he said, that is so bitter, you could drink as much as you want. Since that time, we have a tradition. 6 weeks before Easter, we go to the breweries, we dress up in traditional costumes, gentle lederhosen. Every brewery has a festival, we go there, we have brass music, we are not allowed to dance because it's fasting season, but we are allowed to make jokes about the politicians.